home. The way of the cross leads home. It is sweet to know, as I onward go, the way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home.
What is it again?
I have just received another threat to my life.
The Bible says, "Behold, they shall surely gather, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against thee shall fall for thy sake." I want you to know that the eyes of the Lord is going to and fro from the camp of our enemies and upon us, checking what our reactions would be. We must take consolation from the admonition of our Lord Jesus. The Bible says in John 15 verse 18, "If the world hates you, know that it hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love its own. But because you were not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hates you." My dear, because God is aware of this situation, there is nothing to worry about. When Hezekiah was told he was going to die, rather than worry, he turned to God and prayed. When we allow worry to come in, we begin to take decisions that would uproot us to go to where the Lord has not sent us. Worry will paralyze our faith, which has the ability to change all things and all situations. When we allow worry to come in, it will not come alone. It comes with fear and anxiety. Worry makes a situation seem worse than it really is and proves over again what will never happen, creating unnecessary despair and depression. Worry makes us live like hopeless orphans without the promise of divine help and provision. The Bible says in James chapter 1 verse 2, "My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience." My husband, patience here refers to perseverance. There are some tests that reveal how genuine some metals are, especially gold and diamond. The tests and trials we go through in life are meant to reveal how genuine we are in our convictions and how steady our fellowship with the Lord is. Trials, persecution, suffering, hardship and sorrows may come to a believer, but they often come to test the faith of a believer. However, they are not capable of destroying a real believer. They could destroy superficial, spurious faith. They will expose the folly of a counterfeit saint, and by it, phony believers often fall off the track. Our perseverance through trials is a proof that our experiences are genuine and dynamic. Many a times the scribes and Pharisees sought to kill Jesus, but they could not lay hands on him until he has accomplished. Apostle Paul suffered persecution, hardship, sorrows, and sufferings, but his life was a no-go area until he has finished the gospel that was given to him. Even so are many of the apostles and believers of our time. Every believer has a day of his final test, a final test that will lead to eternal glory, which no one can discern when it comes. When the final test of our Lord Jesus came, he did not confer with flesh and blood. Even as weighty and heavy the sin of mankind was, he did not drop his purpose, rather he looked up to heaven and prayed that the will of the Father be done. Some final test of faith may come through sickness, some through persecution, but if this is not your final test, you will not be moved until you have finished the gospel given to you. You are the storehouse of the Lord, where the Holy Spirit keeps watch, where the evangel, the gospel, the word of God has to be preached to the whole world is kept, where the hope of the lost resides to receive the gospel, and where we have the life of Christ to be lived out. My husband, what I'm saying is, if this is not your final test, there is nothing to worry about. You should not be moved.